Morning students, so today we are going to start next topic, filling of orbitals in atom. Now see, in the last session we discussed about quantum numbers where one quantum number dealt with the orbitals. So orbitals contain electrons. Now how to fill electrons in the orbitals of atom? Okay, this is our topic. So electrons can be filled in the orbitals of different atoms according to some rules. So there are three main rules. One is Aqueous principle, second is Pauli's exclusion principle, and third is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. So we are going to discuss these rules one by one. Very first rule is Aqueous principle. Now the word Aqueous in German means building up. Building up of orbitals mean the filling up of orbitals with electrons. Okay, now what this principle states? It states that in the ground state of the atoms, the orbitals are filled in order of their increasing energies. In other words, electron first occupies the lowest energy orbital available to them and enters into higher energy orbitals only after the lower energy orbital is filled. So what do we understand from this principle? That whenever we have got few electrons and we need to put them in orbitals for writing the electronic configuration of an atom, then we will fill the lower energy orbital first. Once it fills properly, it is completely filled, then we will move ahead. Unless or until we fill the lower energy orbital completely, we cannot go to the next. Firstly, we have to fill the lower energy orbital and then we have to move ahead. Okay. Now see, what should be the order? So this is the order of energies of orbitals. 1s is less than, 2s is less than, 2p is less than, 3s is less than. This way we have to go on. Okay. Now since this is the energy order of orbitals and we know that with the increasing order of energy we have to fill the electrons in the same order. So how electrons will be filled? For filling of electrons we will go in the same fashion. Means we will fill first 1s, then we will fill 2s, and then we will fill 2p, and so on we will go ahead. Okay. Now one thing comes in our mind, how do we know that this orbital has higher energy and this orbital has lower energy? This was decided on the basis of Bohr-Bari rules. Okay. When we are saying that 1s has lesser energy as compared to 2s, then on the basis of these rules we are saying it. Okay. Now there are two rules. Number one, n plus l rule. N plus l rule means we will calculate the value of n plus l, that orbital for which value of n plus l is low as compared to other. Then we will say that this particular orbital has lower energy. Okay. Now sometime we may come across that n plus l values are same. Then there will be application of n rule. Now what is n rule? N rule states that if there are similar values of n plus l, then that orbital which has a lower value of n will have lower energy. Okay. So on the basis of these rules, we have framed this one. This is the way how to find out the energy order of orbitals. Okay, now what we have done, firstly we have arranged s orbitals, then we have arranged p orbitals, then we have written d orbitals, and then we have written f orbitals. Okay, now when we do so, then okay, now see, when we have arranged these orbitals in this way, then we will start moving from this side. We have to go from right to left in the diagonal form. Okay. So we will start moving from this end. That will be the first orbital 1s. Then we will come back again. Okay, then we will come back again and then we will move again in the same way. So it means first there will be 1s orbital, then there will be 2s orbital, then we will move again, then it will come 2p and 3s, then again we will come back and we will start again. The orbitals will be 3p and 4s, then again orbitals will be 3d, 4p and 5s. In the same way, when we will move ahead, then we will get all the energy levels, all the orbitals in the increasing order of energies. Okay, now see two things we have to remember. When we are writing s, then whether it is 1s or it is 8s, maximum number of electrons which can be filled in this are 2. Okay, because there is only one orbital. In case of p, whether it is 2p or 7p, since there are 3 orbitals, so we can fill at the maximum 6 electrons in this. Okay, now when it comes to d orbital, then there are 5 degenerate orbitals. So because of 5 degenerate orbitals, we can fill at the maximum 10 electrons. And in case of f, there are 7 degenerate orbitals, so we can fill at the maximum 14 electrons. Okay, now see, this way it tells us about the main energy level, that in this main energy level these are the orbitals possible. So in first main energy level only one orbital is possible, which is 1s. In second there are 2 possible, in third there are 3 possible sub levels. Similarly, this way we have to move ahead. Okay, so this all you have done in quantum numbers. Now second principle is Pauli's exclusion principle. Okay, now see what it states. It states that no two electrons in an atom can have the same set of 4 quantum numbers. Now what does it mean? It means only 2 electrons may exist in the same orbital, and these electrons must have opposite spin. Okay, so this whole thing can be summed up in another way also, that an orbital can accommodate at the maximum 2 electrons with opposite spin. We can say like this also, an orbital can accommodate at the maximum 2 electrons with opposite spin. Now we have taken an example. Example is of helium. So in case of helium, atomic number is 2, so its electronic configuration will be 1s2. Now for first electron of helium, n value is 1, l value is 0, ml value is 0, and suppose if we say that it is moving in clockwise direction, then for second electron these 3 values will remain same, but the fourth value will be different. It will be anticlockwise. Okay, so this is also we have done in spin quantum number. Okay, so this is Pauli's exclusion principle. Now one more thing comes here. Why do we call it as exclusion principle? So why it is called so? Now you see, if I write this in brackets, then the different values are 1, 0, 0 plus 1 by 2. Okay, now whatever set I am getting for this electron, okay, same set I will never get for any other electron of the same atom. Okay, what does it mean? It means that whatever set of quantum numbers is obtained for an electron, same all other electrons, all other electrons are excluded from that set of quantum numbers. Now when all others are excluded from that set of quantum numbers, then it is given the name exclusion principle. Okay, so it means whatever set is obtained for a particular electron, same set will never be obtained for any other electron of the same atom. Okay, so it is called Pauli's exclusion principle. Now the last principle is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Now what does it mean? This rule is for filling of electrons in the degenerate orbitals. Now, what do we mean by degenerate orbitals? Degenerate orbitals means having same energy. Now, in case of S, there is only one orbital, so there is no presence of degenerate orbitals. So, we will talk about P, D and F orbitals where there are 3, 5 and 7 degenerate orbitals. Okay. Now, what is the rule? Pairing of electrons in the degenerate orbitals belonging to the same subshell does not take place until each orbital belonging to that subshell has got one electron each. That is, it is singly occupied. Okay, now see, this whole thing we can say in other words also. What we can say? We can say no electron pairing will take place in case of degenerate orbitals unless each orbital is singly filled. Okay, so what is the statement? No electron pairing will take place in case of degenerate orbitals when, unless or until each orbital is singly filled. This is Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Now see, we have taken this example. For example, in case of nitrogen, atomic number is 7, so we can write 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Now these 3 electrons are present in 2p orbital or 2p sub level. In 2p sub level, there are 3 orbitals, 2px, 2py, 2pz. So either this should be done or this should be done. Regarding this, it is the principle. Now see, in this case, when we see there is presence of one electron in all the orbitals, no pairing has occurred unless each has occupied one electron. So this will be regarded as correct. But if we see this, we have taken 2 electrons in one orbital and single electron in another, and other one is empty. So this thing is wrong, because no pairing will take place unless each is singly filled. So this is for the filling of electrons in degenerate orbitals. Now whatever we have done today, on the basis of this, you have to solve these assignments. Okay, thank you.